Okay. So their job here at Perfs is to create a false reality, and they do whatever is possible. It's part of this thing they do in this program. They want you to accept this false personality, right? They manipulate you in all different fashion, right? In degrading fashion. It's always degrading. It's meant to make you believe you're somebody you're not. They know who you really are, but they try to change you into somebody you're not. So reality is this, unfortunately for these people, it's just been, the reality has been just too validating of really who they are, what they're part of, right? For example, this man here, because I was putting this program by this organization that spend a lot of money, donate money to very powerful people, and they're more on the conservative side. Now listen, target individuals, we are in all spectrum of politics, and they don't care about that. Politics have nothing to do with you being a target individual. They want people from all culture, all races, all gender. That doesn't, but the people responsible for my targeting are people who are very known for donating a lot of money to very conservative individuals. Some of the people they donated money to are very controversial individual. What I mean by that is that the donations consist of even donating to a man who allegedly, as you can see here, was picking up kids as young as 14 years old. You see that there. Now, for some reason, the current perps, who are just people who now employed me after the fact, I was a target individual, way after, you know, I was already making videos, and they made it clear that when they employed me that they were going to destroy my life. Like, they made it clear that we're going to employ you for the purpose of destroying you in whatever fashion, which is weird that things have happened in certain ways, that the people there, the beginning, as healthy as they were during my employment, are now not as healthy as they used to be. I don't need to go into details, but sometimes you got to understand that karma can come in different fashion. And these people who talk about karma, when they do these nasty things to me, forget about karma that they can actually experience from being involved in this. But listen to this. This man here is called Roy Moore, right? He ran to be a governor, and I think in Alabama in 20, I forgot, to is 18 or so, or around there. But something came out. A bunch of now grown women in their 60s say, hey, when I was a child, this man did these things to me. But in fact, he was even banned from the YMCA. The organization that put me in this program donated money before this allegation and after the allegations. After the fact that there was a bunch of testimonials, right? Which is, you know, this is foul. But, you know, that organization was so pro-conservativeness that, like, I'd rather have this man who's allegedly, you know, doing this thing when he was a younger adult. Not a younger, actually, he was a 35-year-old. He was a mid-aged man in the 30s, late 30s, picking up kids. He would go, like, he would, in this whole, like, thing where, like, he would dress up all fancy, go to the malls as a 35-year-old assistant DA and pick up kids as young as 14 years old. It's crazy, right? And they was like, you know, they make fun of this fact. Now, these people put me in this program, this organization put me in this program, and today, the current perps, which is what I call, they participate in this program, they get the incentives that these governmental entities provide, and they do everything possible to disorient me. It's about countering reality. You see these two people over there? They call it being a war. Because the war is, we're going to block away reality. We're going to make you the threat to children. And matter of fact, for some fucking reason, they are restricted to say the name of Roy Moore. I've said that in front of them. I swear, I've seen them sweat bullets. It seems like this person is like such a ghost, a scary person. There's a whole, you see these people make fun of him. But this is what they get. Because reality is going to hit them. For now, it's their reality, but everything has its time. For me, I'm so thankful that I get to see you. Because before whatever horrible things happens to me, I've seen what life could have been. I could have been you. Just talking about our reality. A grown-ass man and a woman turning to children for whatever incentives. Because what's happening today is, because this man did all these things, and I bring that name over and over, and for some reason, I don't know what kind of restriction they have, but they can't say his name properly. They say his name as if like it's just some kind of mystical being. Like it's blasphemous to say his name. So I noticed that's like, hey, Roy Moore, and I see them sweating. I remember being in the office one day, and they used this like the facade that just comes in all shape. I know it's the government doing that, but for me, they want me to believe it's this like fierce, radical, femme fatale group of young, educated, progressive. It's so nasty. It's just disgusting. And for that reason, I should think that's different. Of course, I know the purpose comes in all shape and form. They try to just make it look like this is everything but this massive government, right? That this is anything but this massive government doing that to us. And so they do say whatever they need to say. Matter of fact, as I'm making this video, I'm actually on the call. And you hear this perp that you see in front of me calling me, I'm their shit, I'm this and that. They can't even say the name of Roy Moore. So I guess I'm their shit, but this shit can say Roy Moore. So what does it make you? I guess I'd rather be their shit. But what I'm trying to say is, they try to make you believe that this is not the government doing these things to you. And the truth is, I know why I'm truly to these people. To the governmental entities that do this. I'm just a freaking guinea pig, to be honest. I'm a test subject. Where they use this technology that can literally rewire your thought process and create imaginations. And what they try to do here is to try to make you believe this false reality where you are this person that you're not. They have this personality implantation. They could make you into something you're not. So these people have already been validated. They involve in gruesome things in regard of this program. This program, they tried to come to me, but bringing in some random things. This program tortures women, men, and children. You've heard the testimony of this poor woman in Austin, where she talks about her genitals or private parts being burnt. This is commonly said. This is nothing new about her. And it's sad. I don't want to be like insensitive, but it's unfortunately a routine tactic to harm women and men in a degrading sexual way. They can burn you anywhere, but they usually target the genitals for degrading purposes. It's part of this kind of misery they want to cause onto you. And so I'm listening to that, right? And not only do you do that, this genital private part targets and harm the private parts, but they do that to not only adults but children, which is so foul. But you know, they're gonna get theirs, you know. To not today they can be God, and when it's time to not be God, they understand that they were God at one point, so you better understand what it means. But then I'm listening to some, because I'm like, first of all, not only you guys are bottom feeders. Because some of these people here say, hey, you know what we're going to dare to do? We're going to dare to implant child porn on your computer. This is our justice. I'm like, that's why I'm so thankful to God. Every day when I make videos, I'm going to have to say thank you. Because the day I ever involve myself in something where putting child porn in somebody's computer is something that is radical and justified and justice, that's the day I know I lost myself. So I have to say thank you, God. I know my imperfection, but trust me, I'm so thankful that I don't have to live a life where this is the things I have to do or even try to even say. Even saying that is degrading. Even saying that. On top of the other things they say right now, as I'm on the call making this video, I hear them say black girls and all this and that. I was like, oh my gosh. You just told me you're going to play child porn. So of course I know what's just going to happen. But going back to this Roy Moore individual. Okay, they are countering the reality that this man, obviously, is as foul as he was allegedly going to the mall, and you know, they make a whole, there's a whole ass sketch about him, right? Where when he was a 35-year-old man, when I think it's late 70s, early 80s, he would be known to be going to the mall dressed in his fancy clothes to go pick up kids, teenage kids, babies. He was 35 years old too. 35 years old. Go and pick up kids as young as 14 years old. And he would say things like, hey, you know, this and that. Not only he picked them up, but he was an assistant here at the time. So you understand, this is somebody who is respecting the neighborhood and the community for being this like powerful being. And some women, when he started running for governor, came out. Guess what they said? I was like, yeah, he did this and that when I was a 14-year-old, when I was a 16-year-old, when I was 17. He was the assistant DA. He made me do this and that. Whole stuff. The employee I worked for donated money after the allegations, okay? This is why I know this name so well, and this is why I use the name, to just bring them back to reality. You guys, me the shit. You guys cannot say this name, me the shit, the nothing, the bottom, whatever you're going to call me, can say Roy more clearly. Me the nothing, the nobody that I am, the dying shit that I will say that and look at you, and you cannot say that. Now, this is crazy. They try to counter these things by making me imagine what this man did as a 35-year-old. Try to make me imagine things like that. My imaginations are being played. Oh my gosh. The mental torture. They have made me... it's disturbing. And I have perps like them, right? They go into the scripts. You are a shit guy, did this and that. He's horny, he's gonna do this and that, and like, and all these horrible things. Oh, they're waiting for you, because what's happening on top of that? And on top of this manipulation of my imagination, they have their children here. These neighbors are having their children prep a frame. They're gonna start making, and this is the people in my brain, so you can only imagine the kind of imagination I'm gonna have. They training their children to say, hey, say that this man did something to you. We're talking about kids. I mean, for me, what they're saying right now, they open the door, it's like, I'm 13 years old, and they slam the door. So I'm guessing that they're around that age. They're going to have their kids around that age say that I did something to them. Matter of fact, they are creating some fucking connections and communication with them that I don't know about. My phone, everything is hacked. All my devices are hacked. Right now, they could be talking to me on the phone, and I'm not even sure. My point is, they can make it look like I'm having interaction that I'm not supposed to be. I'm having interaction with people that I'm not having with. So I'm prepping for that. They say one day they're gonna start the big reveal is gonna start. The kids that they've told to say that I did something to them is gonna come, and I'm gonna be arrested, and they're gonna say you raped this kid. It's so disgusting. Now understand, a parent that is willing to do that to their children is a foul human being. If you're willing to have that on your child's conscience, you deserve things that are magical, and you're gonna get yours. What's disgusting is this perps here. It's not their children that's gonna do that, but they're hyping these kids to do this, so they're gonna get theirs too. Now, how are they countering the reality that's not only they can't say the man here, they can't say his name without saying it in this special way? Listen to this and listen to what they try to counter. So there's this talk show, and in this talk show, they make fun of this man called Roy Moore for the allegation of what he was doing when he was a 35-year-old. Because they can't say his name without saying in a very bizarre, hidden way. They're trying to block it out. Listen to what they're trying to block it out.
Go a food courtin'. And go a food courtin'. More. To the mall to get into the holiday spirit. One woman recalls that she was 14 and working as Santa's helper at the Gadsden Mall in 1977 when Moore first spoke to her and told her she would look pretty. 2 years later, when she was 16, he asked her out on dates. He hit on one of Santa's elves. Well, a true evangelical, he's putting the Christ back in Christmas.
Wow.
And...
wow.
He the sleigh bells jingling, ring, ding, ding-a-ling, too. It wasn't just the mall, folks. One Alabama journalist claims that Moore was also banned from the YMCA for his inappropriate behavior of soliciting sex from young girls. And don't forget, he did that while he was assistant DA.
Okay. Can you imagine that your life right now would consist of blocking what you just heard? You know the part where he says there was like this 14-year-old that this assistant DA was trying to pick up? Can you imagine that this assistant DA was trying to pick up a 14-year-old? Guess how they countered this? Time to play with my imaginations. They're trying to come up with an imagination, me doing what this man did. Because before I say that, before I go into the play of my imagination, today, they're having their kids around the same age of that person, that kid, to say that I did something to them. They try to make me, they're saying they framing me in that fashion. And matter of fact, one of these people, you see a picture here, she said, oh, it's going to be IRS. But because these people look this way, and they're apparently this make them a good people, like they are just a vengeful radical group of terrorists, right? It's all about fucking facade and psyops. They think that these people can do that, and it's gonna look this way. You can feel the whatever the rest, because you present yourself in this fashion. It's a fierce, daring arrest. You're gonna frame me in this way. It's horrible. It's foul. That you think that the way you look makes this different from the reality. Disgusting. But now going into the imaginations. They've tried their best to counter this. They were making me imagine some, like me doing the same thing to some like tiny little Mexican 14-year-old. It's trash. You know how they do that? First of all, they make me think of me when I'm like late teen, early adult, when we used to go to the mall with my friend. And just try to make me imagine some kids. The imaginations. And then they try to make me imagine this like little Mexican kid at the this fast food place. It's like, now you say this thing. How like a whole thing where they were trying to make me imagine, oh, remember when you tried to say these things, they were like little kids. Imaginations. Falsification. That they've been working on to block out the reality, to try to project what this man was doing, picking up kids, to try to make me imagine that. Some of the things they do too, they make me think of me as a high schooler looking at other high schooler in my class and say, we matched. What? Then some of the things they're doing is make me imagine how they make me experience fucking these manipulations, disgusting manipulation. What I remember last year or the year before, I went to Taco Bell. They start creating this. I swear, when I go to these places, I look up. I don't even know what this. I saw the shadow of a fucking employee at Taco Bell. They start giving me some perceptions. Because this is like some small, like Hispanic people. I'm like, oh my gosh. If I see this person, the perception I'm going to have is going to be disgusting. And they're like, no, we mapped it to the way you used to perceive this person, this classmate of yours in high school when you're in high school. That what we're doing there at that time, we're making you experience the perception that you've had when you were in high school looking at another high school student. These games they play with the brain. And it's a lot of things they do to counter reality. But this is nothing unique. Listen, the great thing about what I was able to get before I get to the point of death is I've been validated. They play with the game, with the brain. They create this thought process and imaginations that this technology has the ability to do. Listen to this.
Able to impose any information on the brain of a person, presumably by some kind of waves, which in the mind take the form of voices, thoughts, and images in imagination. In addition to this kind of implanting information that they need, they manipulate the psyche so that the information is written into your memory. Then by stimulating the certain regions in the brain, they can retrieve this information and present it as your own memory. This is the conclusion that can be made judging by the influence they have been making on me with their psychotronic weapons, for example, artificial thoughts, imagination, and mental torture.
Do you know where I got this testimony from? In 2007, there was 100 individuals from all around the world, mostly Americans though, describing being a target individual and what they go through. Guess what? This man, Darius, from Lithuania, this is global. And of course, he calls out the DOD, not the DOD, the intelligence community of the America, because this is global. Wherever I go in the world, it's going to happen to me. And he describes it the same way. It's like, oh, they do this thing where they can even plant imagination in your memories and retrieve that as if it's your real memories. In 2007. And to counter, you see these people here say, oh, when we frame you, the horses are going to rape you. It's so disgusting. Like, listen, God, give me strength for whatever horrible I'm going to go through. But I know that things comes back in ways. Matter of fact, some of the people that you see here said something funny. Because I said, there's to be determined what's going to happen to you. And one of the persons that you see there, I don't know if she's aware or not, but some of the to be determined has been determined. Has been determined. And it was super awkward for her to say that. And I was like, do you know who else is on the call and what's being determined with her? Okay. But they've been creating false memories, false imagination, creating things. I'm like, you just create, painting the story you want to block this. Because you are trying to stop me from thinking about this man who you can't say his name, picking up kids as young as 14 years old. And now you're making me imagine some little Mexican kid that you want me to imagine me saying something to when I was delusional trash. So I'd rather die in the street, be a bum, starve to death, be raped, tortured, die in a hole, than do the things they do. These people have told me they're going to implant child porn on my computers. They're going to have children say that I raped them. And this is going to be the frame they use for me to meet the horses. Them involved in a program that do horrible things to men, women, and children. For me, I'm just going to make sure that they be blessed. Because my death was already... Everything, you know, it was already set before them. They just wanted to partake and enjoy whatever incentive they got of it. Matter of fact, listen to me in 2020, before I start working at this company I'm currently working, speaking about what is happening around the world, which you heard the testimony of this man. This man was in Lithuania, describing what is happening to him.
And I am a victim of organized stalking, electronic harassment, microwave torture, B2K abuse, and I'm asking you to help us end this crime against humanity, which has impacted men, women, children all around the world.
Hi, I'm Wan from Malaysia. My family are targeted individuals. We are victims of cyber torture. And I will not give up. I will fight to the end.
And I'm a victim of organized
We need this to stop.
Electronic harassment. And I'm speaking to you on International Targeted Individual Day. I live in the U.S., in Illinois, and I'm a victim of organized
We need this to stop.
Electronic harassment, microwave torture.
I've been targeted for 9 years.
24/7.
Please become more aware of this crime and those that the crime is being committed against. We need your support and help in ending this crime.
Hello, my name is Wendy Brown. I'm a targeted individual who's living in New Zealand, but my targeting began in California. I'm an American. I'm making this video in remembrance of Targeted Individual Day, our third annual Targeted Individual Day. And I'm asking that every honest-hearted human being open their eyes to a crime?
My name is Jeanette. I am 56 years old, and I live in Baltimore, Maryland. I am a victim of covert electronic harassment and torture. I am a targeted individual.
Wishes to hand down.
Why? Because it hurts. I need help. I need you guys to come get me. It's brutally painful. I have a house, 3 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms, 1st floor, 2nd floor, 2 garage, backyard, land, everything. Can't live in my house. My neighbors are shooting direct energy weapons through my house. I hold my heart like this. You know why? Because it hurts. I need help. I need you guys to come get me. Come get me. Oh, Lord, because I think I'm dying.
So I was saying that in 2020, right, before I start working here with these people, and of course their job is to counter reality. Matter of fact, they were saying, as this woman say, I'm dying. They said, oh, you're dying. It's like, yes, I understand I'm dying, but I'd rather die like this. Because the reality is death is something that we all gonna face. I just rather die this way. And some of you lived the life where you watched me die, and some of you died before I died. But it's okay. Right now, death is something other people go through. They're just enjoying being gods. But this is the level of gods they are. They can't say Roy Moore. Let me say this again. They can't say Roy Moore. They can say Moore, Roy, Rod Moore, Flo Moore, everything but Roy Moore. I don't know why. I don't understand if maybe this man say, hey, these people can better not say my name. But I've seen scary people looking at me saying, oh, we're gonna kill you. And I say, Roy Moore, oh my gosh, I've seen a fear of God in their face and looking straight. I'm like, oh my gosh, this is insane. They are so terrified of this man. I think they're just terrified that, listen, you better follow the scripts here. This is, you better know better. There's laws and rules that you can. As I said, the fear this man has brought to these people is, I don't understand. But at least for me, I just use it as validation. It helps me, and they try to manipulate me. It helps me put things in perspective. Because it's funny how they try to minimize you as a human being. You know, call you a trash. They say that we're gods, you're nothing, you're going to be doing it. I'm like, whatever's going to happen to me. I looked at you in your face, said a name of a man who allegedly picked up kids as 14 years old, and you got fear from it. So for me, I'm so thankful that this is something that I have available to put things back in perspective. To see whose money it is. Matter of fact, not even this perps here. I'm talking about like actually scary looking people who look like they're, you know, perhaps in a different world. Can you imagine somebody looking at you like, oh, I'm going to kill you. And I say Roy Moore. And it's like, oh my gosh. It's like, Jesus. I'm like, okay. Thank you, God. Thank you. How much more can I? And like I said, the framies, they're going to use children to say that I did something to them. While they can't say the name of a man allegedly picking up kids as 35-year-old assistant DA, to the point where he was banned. Come on. If this is not somewhat biblical, I have to look at it as that. Now, with that being said, it's going to be horrible. It's going to be bad. I know. This is provoking to these people. This is a provocation. These people wanted to play this fierce, femme fatale, liberal. You can't even speak about a man who is this super conservative man that was allegedly picking up kids as young as 14 years old. And I'm supposed to think this, you guys are the daring, radical, femme fatale. And you can't say this man's name? Okay. Okay. If this is not some kind of warning that perhaps you should, there's a price to be got. But to try to block this, it's nasty. Listen to what they're part of too. On top of that, you see grown men and women try to block what you... Listen to this.
I just woke up after a pretty rough night. The same thing happened last night as the night before, which was whenever I was trying to go to sleep. The private parts of my body began being burned again, and already on the harming of the... A lot of strange things. I've been doing some research, I guess what it's called, organized stalking. I'm called a targeted individual. But the abuse last night was pretty extreme. I can feel it's going to be the same again today. Already on the harming of the private parts of my body. I don't really know what to do. I tried to go to a doctor to get some kind of pain medicine, because what actually happens to me, what is happening to me, is my actual physical body is being burned. And so it causes me to go into shock, and it's excruciatingly painful. And I have my limitations on the type of the duration and length of pain that I can handle. So it was a couple of weeks ago. I tried to go to the hospital, and they, you know, I talked about military proprietary systems that are used, like, I guess essentially drone technology, which is just manipulating and changing something without touching it or being present. And suddenly there was a man standing outside of my hospital room. I asked him what he was doing there, and he said that I needed to stay in my room. And I asked why, and he said that essentially they wanted to keep an eye on me for a while. And I was like, okay, for how long? And he was like, well, we haven't decided that yet. And I was like, all right, well, I'm leaving. But it definitely felt like if I talk about what's happening to me, that I'm being retaliated against. And I know the logical mind is like, well, everyone can't be involved. But it seems that, I don't know if the government has the right to watch and the proper paperwork, just walk right in and take over a hospital. And it seems that that is a very real reality in a lot of capacities of the things that I faced. So today just kind of just feeling some pretty general fear about my own safety, because the government's burning the private parts of my body. Sometimes it feels like a laser.
So you understand what these people are part of, right? This woman talks about her genital being burned so much that she goes into shock. And I understand that these people are doing whatever possible to counter reality. And the joy they get out of it right now is just to feel like, oh, he's going to be tortured even more and this and that. It's like, okay. Whatever these people are going to go through, me being tortured more or less, it's not going to change reality. And so I'm so thankful I got to see things for what they are. And now, they even try to block out the torture of women in this fashion. Trying to block women being tortured where their genitals are being burnt. You know, at one point, because this woman describes what's happened to her, which is what I've been saying. These people have the luxury to harm people without being there. They don't touch you. But they can do the most damaging things to you. This perp here have done so much damage to my body without being in my presence. You know how they've been calling themselves gods and everything. It's like these guys can't say Roy Moore. Some of these guys ended up being sick. They've cut my organs, done all these things to my body. I'm like, okay, you're going to get yours. I remember when I said that. Okay. When it happens, I don't care if it happens when I see it, but it will happen. Now, one thing this woman said is like, this is happening to me without being touched or anybody's present. It's like, oh, touch, I touch, she touched it. Oh my goodness. You know what they try to do? They try to circle back to me as a kid. They try to make me imagine, no, she touched it, she touched it. Try to talk about the dumb thing I did as a child. Make me imagine a version where these things, their version of reality, where they want me to imagine me going through what I go through, what I did. Do whatever I did as a child and try to make me imagine, no, she touched it. No. Trash, you wish. But she said something about how they're able to do these harmful things to the genitals. Abuse her by harming the private parts. Matter of fact, at the end she say, the government is burning my private parts. Listen to a four-year-old where her private part is being harmed. It's disgusting.
And I also work with a four-year-old little girl with Down syndrome, as well as her five-year-old sister who also has Down syndrome. I observed both of these girls suddenly grabbing their genitals in pain and verbalizing, ow. I observed this at least on one or two occasions for each of them during their separate sessions. During one session, I observed one of my three-year-old clients suddenly grab his crotch and lean forward in his chair. Then he made a frightening grimace of severe pain. I asked him what was wrong and if he needed to use the restroom, but he said no to having to use the restroom and was not able to verbalize anything more due to his language delay.
Can you imagine these people try to come up with this version and exaggeration of what I did as a child? I'm involved in a program that not only harmed the genitals or the private part of women, but children. You heard the four-year-old with Down syndrome. You heard the five-year-old with Down syndrome. Both of them grabbing the genitals because they're feeling pain in the private part. You heard a three-year-old feeling pain in the private part and grabbing the private part and looking at the woman and be like, looking like he was in pain. This trash is so foul. And try to counter that. I try to be like, no, but remember what you did as a kid. You nasty low life. Not only are you blocking out the fact that you can't say this man's name, a man that picked up kids as young as 14 years old, but making me imagine some non-existent reality, making me imagine some 14-year-old and make me create some imagination of me talking to some 14, to try to project the reality of what you do to children. Sorry. Project the reality of what Roy Moore was allegedly doing. Because you can say Roy Moore in this clear way. You have to say in this fucking scared way. I don't know. I honestly don't understand the issue there. But there's obviously a restriction that they can't say the name with me hearing it clearly. I hear them say sometimes when I can't hear them clearly. They say everything else clearly. If I look at them and say Roy Moore, I can see them turning red and sweating. As if I'm saying a name of like a blasphemous God that they shouldn't be talking about. But they can say it in this fierce way when I can't hear it. Or when I'm not sure if they said it. But if I say, hey, perps, say Roy Moore. Yep, can't say that. They can't. And so now because the humiliation that they can't say the name of men who did these things to children. Or allegedly. They're making me imagine what he did. Life is about countering reality and projecting reality. Then they talk about me as a child. Try to exaggerate what I did as a child. While they do this sexual torture to children. Please listen. So this is what it's about. For this purpose, to enjoy what they do, they counter reality. Can you imagine trash like that? Look at where they're sitting in. saying it's war. No, it's not war. They wanted to enjoy what they can do to me remotely while creating a storyline. But in every way, it's been embarrassing. You know this trash over there who's saying, oh, it's going to be a server. You know what they're saying? They're saying that they're going to plant child porn and it's going to be seen on my server. These people working for governmental entities that have problem with child porn distribution and accessing and trafficking. But because these people present themselves, these people who have problems saying Roy Moore present themselves as this fierce femme fatale, because it come from them. It come from this trash who will make me serve. These people who can't say Roy Moore work for governmental entities that have problem with pedophilia and torture children will frame me by having their fucking excuse my language, have their children say something about me doing something to them to frame me. Listen, I know this bottom feeder. Who you're seeing here is definitely, they look like elites in comparison to who's actually involved themselves 24/7. They're losers. Trash. And I'm so happy, and I heard this one of these perps say, their joy is to see me suffer. I was like, please let that be your joy. Let that be the joy they have. Let enjoy that as much as you can. But you'll see. When you get yours, while you got yours, enjoy. I don't want to bring up certain things that made me understand there's such thing as you're going to get yours. Matter of fact, I remember saying that to a few people, and some of them have theirs. Got theirs. Not even something I wish onto them, but it happened. One literally killed himself. Literally, I remember saying he killed himself. And I remember saying, "Oh, you get yours, Dennis." Because they were saying, "Oh, awkward." After they were forcing me to have them, the man was suicidal all along. Obviously, he was suicidal before he was involving himself in this program. Before he was doing that to me. So I'm like, go ahead. God, give me strength, because these people involved in a program that does these horrible things, being humiliated in every way possible. They can't even say, you know, yesterday was so bad that somebody couldn't say his name. Starts talking about how, because they're going to rape me this way, that, and this, and that. My rectum's going to look this way. Can you imagine? Because he was complex that he couldn't say the name of this man. Don't worry. This is already a degrading life that you're living. And you're going to see me be tortured in whatever ways that now you even bring that up to try to counter what you're involved in. God give me strength for the horrible torture that I'm going to go through. But these people have been humiliated by reality. And that's not only the beginning. It's only the beginning. I'm telling you, it's only the beginning. This is just a warning, of, okay, right now you're God. As a God, you can't even say the name of this man who picked up kids as young. You heard how they were making fun of him. Making the YMCA song. But calling it the assistant DA. Can you imagine calling yourself God, but you can't even say it? And call me, I'm their shit, you're the shit. Okay, I'm your shit. Saying Roy Moore, say it, God. Now, let me just say that. This is the only reason I'm saying this name is because the people who put me in this program that are super conservative to the point where they will donate money after those allegations came out. Donate money to this man. And so I'm like, oh, you guys are presenting yourself as this fierce femme fatale. This strong, all this bravery and daring. Say his name. With your money. Say his name clearly without saying any of this. You can't. So I understand who's running the show. Because for some reason, there's some restriction to the point of even saying this person's name. That's how lucky I got. Because it helps me see them for what they are. That this facade was just a psyop. That this feminism, this progressiveness, this femme fatale is like all bullshit. Ah, children, you can't even say this name. But you can destroy my organs. And you know why? Because in the program that torture women and children, that can fuse my organs, that can destroy my all my organs in different ways. But it was at a cost, and you will know. And because you, this perps wanted to do it and be like, oh, when we do it, we're just there. We're just like this badass fan. Oh, it's trash. It's so nasty. In my brain, they're even bringing up the things they try to... Listen, it gets to the point where I was with this woman. She was a young adult. I was introduced to this woman by somebody who was with her before, who is a perp, who has hooked up with her. He's older than me. And I talked to her because they're like, oh, how old is she? How old is she? I got her. I started doing the math. Very basic. Very, very, very basic. I even used my calculator to in the math that consists of like three digits, like 3 minus 20, 20, 20, 3 minus things like that. I was like, let me use my calculator because these trash are going to try to even gaslight me. It's like, oh, you did the wrong math. I said, Jesus, that was the most easy math ever possible. And I still did it on the calculator just because I know my brain can be still manipulated. It's like, oh, but today when I do something off, which my brain is even more fried than ever, it's like, you see, wrong math. I was like, you're such a pathetic lowlife. They are living off reality that is falsified. And they are pushing me into insanity because I'm hearing somebody say, oh, you're crazy. It's like, yes, I am crazy. Or I'm losing my mind because I'm being manipulated this way. And whatever horrible things I'm going to go through, I'm just so thankful I get to see things. And they're like, oh, no, actually, you're not crazy. We're going to make sure that you involve, you put somewhere with crazy people that are going to do horrible things. Like, I understand. You think that's going to compensate for what you deal with. You are to the level where you can even say a fucking man who's allegedly picking up kids as young as 14 years old while you are here framing me in this way. And you don't see this magical aspect of things that you're so daring that you're not even capable of saying this person's name. You still want me to be thinking this is your money when you can't even see this person's name. You say you protect women and children when this program tortures women and children in ways that's horrible. You're so pedophilia-centric that the entities that run this program not only have this tactic of manipulating the brain in this way, but are ranked top tier for child porn trafficking. And you are saying that you are daring to put child porn on my computers because when you do it, it's fierce. It's your justice. Fucking trash. Look at this lowlife where they are targeting visual. I'm so thankful I'm able to see things where they are. Listen to this.
According to Child Pornography Watchdog Internet Crimes Against Children Child Online Protective Services, the Defense Department network consistently ranks in the top tier of internet service providers for trafficking child pornography.
The Pentagon workers, be they civil or military or otherwise, already submit to a gauntlet of daily scrutiny just going in and out of work. Is it fair then to the tens of thousands who are completely innocent to further allow that much more government intrusion into their, you know, their digital devices or the things that they're dealing with on their computers?
Well, remember that what's being talked about here is not an intrusion into someone's personal device or even their home. This is about saying Department of Defense computers are being misused to share, to spread, to access child pornography. And
how much humiliation can one have? And by the way, they try to counter the ranking. That's why I stopped at the ranking. But it's top tier ranking. They even actually stimulated me when the number came in. I didn't want to just deal with it at this point. And then it made me think of some nasty reaction to make me have toward a child. Because this is what this technology is capable of doing. They rewire your thought process and can make you have emotions and reactions that they want you to have. They play with your libido. They play with your thought process. They play with your emotions. They can manipulate all of that with this technology, coming from the same entities that have problems with these pedophilia issues. And they try to find ways to make you feel guilty for whatever. things, and then even creating the storylines. But you heard what they do to women, to children. There are things I can't say. The sexual tortures. And still want to be presented in these ways. But I'm so thankful for Roy Moore. For me, that is a name that, listen, he has nothing to do with me. He has nothing to do with me, but to hear a perp saying his name in a fashion they're so scared of. They're so scared of. For example, somebody just say Roy Moore while I said it, because I wasn't planning on hearing him say anything. He's saying it in a way that makes it hard to hear him say it. It's such a, it humbles them to remind them how bottom feeder is, that you have to time how to say this person's name. You have to time how to say this person's name. He's not God. He's somebody people make songs about. Assistant DA. But I'm so thankful. Somebody who I don't know, have nothing to do with my targeting, is now for me a way that validates me to see them for the low life that they are. That Roy Moore. As I said that to hear if they're going to say it. Is somebody now that validates me that these people are just bottom feeders. Thank you, God. Because Roy Moore, once again, I just want to make sure I say clearly to hear if they're going to say it in a brave way, in a daring way. Let me repeat that. Roy Moore. Let me do a third check. Roy Moore. They call it, they say more. I heard more. Is now a validation. And I'm so thankful that I have that to make me see them for the low life that they are. Just to wrap up everything else, because the facade has been so destructive to them. Now, on top of the fact that they can't say the name of this pedophile. Oh, sorry, alleged pedophile, I should say. They are working for a program that clearly uses rape in such a common way. And I've been validated. Obviously, you heard this woman talk about her genitals being burnt and her going to shock. These people can't say Roy Moore. I'm involved in a program where it clearly is mentioned that they rape women. So, as I'm being told how I'm going to be framed and then they're going to rape me, it's like, that's the justice. It's clear that they rape women. For me, the reason why they try to make me, they were like, try to have this battle in my head. It's like, oh, it's what you did to Courtney, what it was. I was like, listen, I'm, one thing is for sure. You are for sure aware that you're involved in a program where rape is commonly applied to women. You are not doing any justice to anybody when you involve yourself in a program that clearly rape women and even burn their genitals. I will never let people who are involved and try to counter this here.
It's already being used. I mean,
if you talk to the victims, the PIs, one of the worst breakdowns, and it's pretty common. I think I can say the word simulated rape, and forced or
you
yes.
You can say anything you want. This is the internet.
Okay. And so simulated, orgasms and rape is
right.
Extremely common and
right,
especially violating for women. They complain about that torture breakdown the most.
So you hear that? I didn't come up with these things. I didn't come up the fact that somebody says, hey, listen, rape is such a common thing in this program that women are complaining about it the most. You are validated that these people are just the bottom feeders in this program. For some reason, they're restricted to say the name of this person who allegedly was doing the things that you just heard. You heard the horrible things they do to not only women, but children. And what they do to women is not only just rapes, but they are also torturing them in regard of burning their genitals, electrocuting their genitals, and other disgusting rape-like tactics. And it's common. And they are here doing everything possible to counter reality. And now, finding ways to counter the fact that they do these horrible things. They even having their children coming up with frames. So then they say, oh, then they'll rape you there. It's like, I'd rather get raped wherever than be involved in a program that does these things to women, that rapes women in these ways, that destroy their life and children, and work for governmental entities where you heard the issues they have. Obviously, this woman said it very well. The technology that they're utilizing onto us, a technology that is super advanced. These trash that you see here can do things to my body remotely. But they wanted to enjoy what this technology is capable of doing, living a deluded reality and even countering reality. Not with me. They will get what is needed to be done to them. The storylines, the fantasy, they've put together this bullshit story like for whatever you, they will get theirs. In the meantime, God give me strength. Because you heard the horrible torture they said they're going to make me experience. I do believe that. Why? Because they've been humiliated by the reality. To the point where it's stories of all sorts. I mean, I'm a father to a 9-10-year-old kid now. Boy, they even gave him a name. This story that they tried to project onto me from Roy Moore. These clowns are clowns, but do horrible things in this clownly way. And can't even say Roy Moore. But tell me how I'm going to fight. Tell my talking visuals, stay strong.